Hi everyone, welcome to this another video in MarketTalk YouTube channel. Hope the weekend trade was good and profitable, but today the market has not given much opportunity for intraday traders to make money. But however, definitely there are few opportunities given by Bank Nifty and Nifty also today. But for positional shorters, it was a good money making day. It was. Let us understand what happened today in the market, the view for the Nifty, Bank Nifty, and view for the coming days also. So let's start with the disclaimer. Please read the disclaimer. Please take your own decisions. I am just giving this video for the education purpose. Let's start with trading mantra for the day. Option buyer need not need to wait for the right opportunity, while option seller can entry at any time at his own liberty. That is the beauty of option seller, but you have to enter at the right time. So the, our Eichler Fisher transform indicator is one of the indicators that gives you the right opportunity for to enter. We'll see this also today on how this was giving the opportunity for us. Every day I've been covering that, and we will be very good opportunity given by the Eichler Fisher transform indicator. Let's start with the key data. This is important data, FI data. Today if you see here, again another 8000 contracts they squared off the positions, futures long positions. Still they are long only, but they cut down their long positions, and they're building their, not building actually, they're maintaining this 115,000 put long puts actually. Now clients are building the long positions, they're having slight long positions. Last time it was short, they've been completely short, and they're completely not having a good times actually. So they reverse the position, now their market is started reversing now. So FIs are not building shorts. Once they start building shorts, then the down move can be serious. So, but let us see, because however the futures long is not so much actually, but they have enough position in the long puts. Let's go to the charts and see what happened in the charts. So we'll start with the power of 2. So in case of power of 2, let us understand what happened. Both are in the sell signal only. Yesterday, not yesterday, before that, no, we got the sell signal here. Here this is the time when we got the sell signal here on 3rd September, which is nothing but yesterday, 11:30. 11:30 is the time afternoon we got sell signal here. After that, never we crossed above the 200 McGinley. Okay, 200 McGinley still is the down only. Okay, till down only. You can see here, never it made a cross. Unless the 20 McGinley cross over 200 McGinley, we'll be on the sell side only. Should not be on the long side. And these are times when the power of this McGinley, this Eichler Fisher transform indicator gave the opportunity for intraday. So this is a place where the go long position was there, where it was rejected, the price rejected and started coming down. And this is a place where the price started moving down, and this is a place you should have shorted the 23,500 calls. It is very good time, almost 300 rupees it was trading at the time. I shorted, and I think the 50 points we got there. So this is a place you have to short the calls, and this is a place you have to short the puts. But thing is that last moment shorting the just half an hour before is not advisable, because you need to square the positions also. So this is how the this power of 2 is there for Bank Nifty. Let us see for Nifty. Nifty is also in sell signal only. See when we got signal here, the same time here, there was a touch up, touch and go here. This was the place where touch and go was there around 250, yesterday's close time. After started continuously falling below the 200 McGinley. If you see here 200 McGinley, after 200 McGinley, it gave a crossover, and then still now we are on the sell signal for the power of 2. So we should not be on the long side as of now, because both Nifty and Bank Nifty are in the sell signal. Today what happened in the levels also, just as watch the levels, market opened below the go short, go long everywhere. Okay, so this short breakout also, below the short breakout, whenever below short breakout you should not attempt to go long. But however, the power of 2 gap theory I told you, where the McGinley 200, McGinley 20 is there, and the price very very far below this. So that is the reason I told in the morning. And also 11,300, I told 11,300 put to short. Okay, this is the place, 11,300 put was available for 100 rupees, 105 or 110, something I believe, 100 rupees. So it is very safe bet to short the put that time because of the power of 2 gap theory. So whenever there is a, like for example, McGinley is 20 above and 200 big is there and the price opens gap up, then that time the gap theory works for the shorting call options. Okay, so easily you can get 50 points in this theory when you see gap down or gap up. So the power of 2 helps you in capturing the opening moves actually. Now let us go to the other charts. So before we go to the other charts, the weekly charts, let us see here what happened for Nifty. Nifty, there is a bearish engulfing in case of Nifty, little alarming situation, but definitely one should be cautious. This is a signal. Yesterday we saw about the moon cycle, where the 3rd September was a full moon and the impact we can see. So till 17th September, new moon will come. Till the time, be cautious, it could be on down days. Okay, so full moon cycle, just keep in your mind, it is not for trading, it is for the leading indicator, it is a guiding indicator, we can tell. Okay, so guidance purpose you should take, most of times it works fantastically. And let us see for Bank Nifty also. So let us see for Bank Nifty what happened. As I told you, like Bank Nifty, definitely it is weak, but relative to Bank Nifty, Nifty is more weakness. So below, once it grows below the previous week candle, which is nothing but 22410, it does not close below the previous week candle, but however it is a reversal candle, and now this week low is 22878. So if we sustain below this low, then it is going to be weak for the coming days. Let us start with the Nifty hourly chart. So consolidation zone was there, and then we went above this. Now we are reversing. Then we should see, as I mentioned, that looks like we are going to test 11,000 levels in the month of September. Looks very, very highly, because considering the FI data, considering technicals, considering the moon cycle and Lakshman Rekha, everything is giving us a very good indication for that actually. So be on the short side, any bounces will be temporarily used for shorting actually. Let us see the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty also same thing. So the actual this gap is there, so we should be able to come and see, test this gap. 22,000 levels easily we should be able to test. So next week we should see another 1,000 points down move, which is can test 22,000 levels also. So be ready for 22,000 levels in Bank Nifty for testing this gap. Good, Bank Nifty is weak, but not so much weak like Nifty, because it has given a big run up. Let us see the first setup for the Nifty and Bank Nifty, Ichimoku cloud setup. So today if you see here what happened in this Ichimoku cloud, exactly we got the support there. Okay, once this broken, then after some time this Achilles and this Tenkans and this blue line should come down also. Okay, over a period of time it will start pulling this Tenkans and also below Kijun Sen. Once it sustains below this 340 levels, 340-300 levels, then this is going to be very weak for Nifty. We have to see the crossover here. This crossover has to come to confirm the down move, and the future cloud should be also coming in red actually. Eagle Fisher already has given a sell signal for us for 3 days back on the big signal. No, when the down move came on Monday, that time we got almost the red signal here, the down move, for down move. Let us see for the Bank Nifty. For the Bank Nifty again, we got a good support here at this Kijun Sen. Once that crossover comes here, but slowly it will happen, because futures, once the FA started building the shorts, then the ferocious down move can come possibly. But however, looking at the global markets, the weakness is there, and the people may not get opportunity for entering the shorts. So unless you have a short position, you will not be able to capture on Monday. But however, like I mentioned in the Telegram channel, that I have a bull put spread, because considering the option pain data, maybe we can see some bounce. If not getting, then because I have protection in the puts also, I bought the puts. So definitely time value I should be getting, and also a short 11,200 call also in addition for me as a protection, because definitely I need to have consideration of the bearish move which is going to come. At the same time, I need to consider the option pain data also. It's not that all the month end option, everything which is trading at 200-300 points premium will come down immediately. VIX is also not so much, it's just 22 levels. So once it started picking up 20-25 levels, then we should see some aggressive down moves actually. As of now, just it's a trailer. I feel like it's a trailer. So get ready for the big moves in the coming days. before 17th September, we should see all the down moves, whatever, and then we should see some stop. Let us see the next setup. Bollinger Band. So coming to the Bollinger Band, we closed below the Bollinger Band 20 moving average, the midpoint. Definitely is the confirmed weakness for Nifty. So we saw the border at case, it was for HMO cloud, but in case of Bollinger Band, it is a confirmed down move now. Now the target is 11,152, the bottom of the Bollinger Band. Arun is still in the buy mode only, but whoever bought here, for them comfortably they can sit here because they bought at 9,720. So there is a big cushion is there for them. But who are entering now, there is no cushion. Already there is a cushion is finished now. Now everything is gone. Once we close, go below this big candle low, 11,325. Then the game is finished, okay, and definitely we are going to test 11,150 in no time. In 2-3 days time we should test that. But option supporters, option put traders will see how they come to the follow-up, because option pain for Nifty moved from 11,500 to 11,400 now. During that it went to 11,450 and then again it came to 11,400. So we should see 11,300 option pain on Monday possibly, considering the down move if it is continuing on Monday also. And for Bank Nifty, we have support still at 20 moving average, but in no time it will get broken. Let us see whether it is broken. Once it is broken, then we should see the lower Bollinger Band 2150 levels also to come in Bank Nifty. Let us see the third chart setup, Heikin Ashi. What Heikin Ashi tells? It's a clear sell signal from Heikin Ashi. It is open equal to high. So once we break this Nifty 11,200 levels, then it is the game is finished. The Heikin Ashi, once it close below 11,200, 11,000 levels come very sharply. And then here we are also seeing the crossover here for DA plus DA minus crossover is there. But trend is becoming weak little. But however, look for shorting the collar, because buying put option very very costly. It actually, after the down move, if you see 11,400 put option, which is the intrinsic value is 50 rupees, is trading at 140 rupees. Okay, so just use up the opportunity by shorting the call options. That's the only best opportunity you have. Or what you can do is, for example, now the Nifty is trading at 11,333. Now assume that the market opens at 11,300 level. Then see, look for opportunity to create a short strider at the lower level, 11,300 level. So you have very good cushion and the call option also, put option also. And also you can add a ratio spread also, where you can tell, okay, for you can short two lots of calls and one lot of put. If you are continuously, if you are trading on the downside, then your call will save you from the put also going down, because put will not go down so much unless we go to 11,200 levels. Option pain is that indicating you that it is 11,400. Okay, so that's a guiding factor for you also, option pain. So just do the ratio spread with the option short straddle at the right strike price, so for you to make money on the intraday also. Now let us see the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty also has just, it's almost about break 21,785. This is a level, but Heikin Ashi will take time, maybe like 2-3 days time it will take, unless there is a big fall. So 21,800 levels is where we can see some sell signal to come from this trend. But however, this DA minus is yet to give a sell signal. Trend is in the slightly upper hand only, so it could be a trap also sometimes. So be cautious. Use to capture time value, because don't buy naked shorts or selling naked futures is always risky. Try to capture 50 to 100 points in the options on every move. So whether you should not bother about whether market will gap down or gap up on Monday or next trading day. Once you are cool with your strategy, whether the market opens gap down or gap up or it doesn't, it opens flat, you should not bother at all. Your strategy should be such a strong way to take care of your trading positions. So then your strategy is very strong. Let us see the fourth setup. Fourth setup is a moving average crossover, 20 day moving average and 50 day moving average crossover. Here also it is very very clear that only below 11,000 will come the sell signal. But already the awesome oscillator has given a sell signal here by giving almost 5 days continuous red bars. 185 is the level now. Once we go below zero, then the swift down move can come here from the oscillator also. Coming to the Bank Nifty, here also last 2 days there are red bars. You can see here red bars are coming here, but below zero the trend will be confirmed to be on the downside. And here also 50 moving average is the first support here 22,281. So everything is pointing to around the 22,200 to 300, 500 levels. That's a range you are seeing a support. So but you have time for that support to be broken actually. So don't just do naked shorting, because the market, everybody is aware that there is a big down move came on March, and again nobody is be out of this big panic move actually what happened in March. So once the down move starts, everybody definitely recollect that what happened in the March. My thinking is that if everybody is thinking the same way, the market will not behave in the same way what majority people expect. Now definitely majority people are expecting that the market will move like March, how it came in the down move. But there is a chance that it will do a contra also. But we should be ready to go for this down move also. But follow the option pain. Okay, just go with the move. Any down move definitely, because already the call options are trading at very low values actually. Now shorting the call option on the closing level, closing time will not be giving you much opportunity. You should take intraday trades only using the short straddle strategy which I told you, on the right strike price below the option pain. So that's the right strategy you should take, because you will not get the opportunity, because tomorrow if the gaps up again, the option what it showed which is very low value will kill you. Okay, so take always enter the strategy and exit the strategy also. Don't do anything partially. Okay, now the fourth setup also is finished. Now let us move to the key data. So coming to the key data, the PCR is bearish 0.7 levels. It's not oversold also. It is normal bearish. Only it goes to 0.5 level, it is bearish. The VIX also I expected around 25 levels to go, but surprisingly it stayed around 22 levels only. And Lakshman Rekha is in sell signal. This month Lakshman Rekha has given us almost 247 points for Nifty and 824 points for Bank Nifty. So stop loss will be around 23,781 for Bank Nifty and 11,535 for Nifty in the futures level. So we have enough cushion for us to protect us from the shorts. So in case of FIDA data, we saw that already futures we are 9,000 contracts long for by FIs. Still they are not in the shorts completely short, but however long puts they have enough 1.1 lakh contracts, but the clients are shorted the puts actually. This is a disastrous. These people are shorted puts, and I think Monday there could be gap down, but another 100 points gap down could be there. I don't see more than that actually, and there could be bounce also. So use up bounce to short only. And then IVs, if you see call IVs are very high, there is a big demand expecting that market will not go down continuously using the opportunity, because these people are not still in the bearish mode, they are bullish. That's the reason we are seeing the call IVs are high. And then let us see the moving averages. We have broken the 20 moving averages for Nifty, but however for Bank Nifty still slightly we have just 200 points away, and not much time left for Bank Nifty to break this support. So this week if you see, entire thing is bearish only. Weekly trend is broken. 200 points we got on the downside below the weekly midpoint, and Bank Nifty got 419 points. But compared to last week, the up move, we not got so much of up move. Definitely let us see what's there in the charts for the next week also. Coming to the levels, 23,350 is the long breakout, and 22,700 is a short breakout for Bank Nifty, and 11,441 long breakout, and 11,262 short breakout. So plot these charts in the levels. This is the futures levels, and once you get these levels, only you go levels short only at this level. Okay, go long only at this level. Don't go in expectation of the moves. Let us go to the learning time. I'm not feeling well actually, so that's reason I'm just speaking a little fast. I'm not able to talk properly. Learning time. Please like the video to motivate me. In the learning time, we are going to see about GAN, important GAN rule, GAN number 26. Number 26 is the GAN important number of days. So it is works very well in the weekly chart. Okay. Now let us see, this is a weekly chart, so monthly chart. Let us plot the weekly chart actually. So in the weekly chart, what we'll do is we should take a key important top and bottom. Okay. Now let us take some key important bottom and tops. Okay. So this is one key important low. Okay, let us take this key important lows. From there, 26 candles, 26 weeks is what you have to take. So let us, what you can do is drop down, see date range, select here date range. Let us take this 26 bars. Okay, 26 bars. 26 bars we have plotted now. Now from this we want to extrapolate for the next 26 days. How to do that? So go here, drop down, cyclic lines, click cyclic lines and click here and then extend like this. 26 bars we got, okay. Now on the forward side, let's just see what's happening. See the bottom, exactly 26 weeks. Here the 26 weeks bottom. Here exactly we are seeing a trend reversal 26 weeks. Now next 26 weeks, we are going to see some good trend change. Okay, so it could be flat or bottom also, anything is possible, but definitely it is a good trend reversal point. You can see the past also, you can plot like this for the past also. How to plot? So same way, just select here and here you select in this one line and then drag and drop like this. Okay, now doing like this, you can see the key bottoms, everything automatically coming automatically in the weekly chart for Bank Nifty. You can see here the top and bottom, it could plus or minus 1 or 2 weeks, but however you can be able to capture the good bottoms and tops most of times. You cannot tell 100% accurate, but definitely it is giving 80% accuracy most of times. This is only, these are guidance factors, okay, but certain times it will not work for a particular instrument, certain times it will work very good for particular instruments. Let us see the Nifty. The same thing we will try for Nifty also. Nifty, let us take the key bottom levels. Let us take this bottom only again. So this here will take 26 bars we have taken, and then the cyclic lines here, cyclic lines, and plot here and plot here 26. Now see the tops here, we got in between, but however from here again another move came, and here 2-3 weeks before itself we got some bottom, and then here top, exact top here we formed here, okay, 1 week before. After this capturing this around 743, how many points we got? 700 points we got here almost. So here if you get, you are getting enough bottom, then you should book profits. It's not that you should wait. Here we got the top bottom here. Now we are getting the top. So after being the such a big rally, so Nifty is looks very very highly ready for the good correction in the next 26 day weeks, which is almost February 2021. So 26 weeks complete on February 2021. So whatever the move up move possible looks like that this week, whatever the high we made here, which is around 11,800, we should not be broken on the upside. There is a high chance that we should going to be sustaining below this level till the year end, and also for the coming times, which is till February 2021. So for the next 26 weeks, the trend is ready for you. You should be able to appreciate this for this. WD GAN for giving us this good, interesting study for us. Please subscribe, like the channel. Hope you like the video and it's going to be interesting for you. So get ready for the down moves in the Nifty. But it'll be slowly and steadily is going down. Not, may not be like this way it's going down in the past what happened in the March. It'll be slowly grinding down moves, because everybody on this panic buy the puts, and then they will not be able to make money like what they have done in the March. It will be a different style of a bearish move possible. Okay, so just understand the markets, move with the wave. Thank you.